Hello, welcome. My name is Avi, and today I'll be talking about maintaining your peace. I feel like I've had a relationship with the word peace. You know, when I grew up, I thought of the word as being, you know, something associated with signs by hippies, an unrealistic, comfortable notion. But now I love peace so much. There's nothing better than feeling peaceful. I see peace being connected with acceptance, that I can't be peaceful unless I accept exactly how everything is. If I can't accept how everything is, then I'm going to struggle. I'm gonna lose my peace. And I can hear in my head the opposing argument for accepting how everything is. Well, how about this atrocity, and how about this that needs to get better, and all the changes that need to be made in the world? And I agree, but trying to create change without accepting how things already are doesn't lead to the positive results that are possible if you maintain your peace. So it's almost like this experiment that I have in my mind. Like, I accept things how they are completely, but I'm still going to work toward making things better, to improve injustice. Often I think yogis can be associated with not taking action. I think that's wrong. It doesn't have to be that way. Yogis have the potential to make as much of a difference as anyone in the world. Action, again, doesn't need to be taken from a place of feeling like things aren't okay. I think actually the best results will take place if I am peaceful while I am trying to improve simultaneously. And what does it mean to hold on to my peace? You know, that's a question. It doesn't mean that I can't fluctuate. It doesn't mean that I can't even express frustration or anger or sadness or anything like that. Actually, I think peace encompasses all of those other emotions. But again, peace is still accepting everything along the way. Okay, I'm angry right now. That's okay. When it's not okay, then I lose my peace. And that's a very odd thing, to be angry while at the same time being okay with being angry. But it somehow makes all the difference. In one, I am accepting my humanity, that it's okay for me to be angry or express frustration, for me to be a human being and be free and to do what feels right in the moment. The other one feels almost shameful. While I'm being angry, I am fighting with others, I'm fighting with myself, I'm not happy with what I'm doing. It's almost like this fear, I need to get out of here, I need to get out of this situation, I'm not okay with it. For me, it's not how I want to live. I want to live experiencing joy, being grateful with what I've already been given, and kind of just surfing along the way, surfing all of the different ups and downs and turns that come. You know, I think of something that Swami Satchidananda says really affected me. I read it. It was, even if God comes to disturb your peace, don't let God disturb your peace. I was like, what? I remember laughing when I read it. I was like, whoa, this guy is serious about his peace. And I've reflected on that a lot, and it's so awesome. So I invite you to investigate how it feels to be peaceful, to be accepting of everything. That it doesn't necessarily mean to be lazy and not to do acts of goodness and justice. Please let me know if you have any questions or comments, and I'll see you next time.